Guys, we all are gonna die one day, and our air conditioners are gonna be the reason for it. Know how to prevent that? Stay tuned till the end of the video. This is Prateek, you're watching Prehistoric Polymath. Without any further ado, let's get into it. Whoa. So, how are we gonna die because of our air conditioners? Well, basically, let's understand how ACs work. ACs basically take out the heat which is inside the room and put it outside, basically increasing the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So, the refrigerants which they use, which is HCFs, homochlorofcarbons, are in very small quantity in greenhouse gases, but they do trap a lot of heat by which the atmosphere and the earth gets hotter and glaciers start to melt and sea levels start to rise. So there was a meeting where more than 100 countries came together and decided that we should stop the use of HFCs and develop the new technology to use HFOs. So HFOs are basically homochlorolefins. In developing countries, you know what happens is people are earning more money, so they want better lifestyle, so they'll be upgrading, so everybody will be having AC. So there was a study which said that that'll be one time that our earth will get so hot that our ACs will not be able to cool even from the inside. So what is the way for preventing this is turn off your ACs. Ever heard someone say you're one decision away from completely different life? Just do it. Turn off your ACs and it's all right, guys. Use fan, use sustainable amount of energy like a fan, or you know, we need to come up with certain technology that it'll give you the same cooling effect and thus not increase carbon dioxide as well. You will say, Prateek, let's just make a smoke machine and let's just make a fog machine out of dry ice. Well, what is dry ice? Solid form of carbon dioxide, thus also increases carbon dioxide, which we don't want to do because you know, we breathe oxygen, not carbon dioxide, right? So that's all, guys. Turn off your ACs and you know, stop global warming. So you might ask, how much my AC is contributing to the global warming? Well, it is not that much contribution when the AC is installed. If the AC is quite old or if you throw your AC away, the refrigerants might leak and that might cause to the contribution of greenhouse gases. So how long till I have to give up my air conditioner? Well, quite frankly, if you are in a developing countries, about 10 to 15 years probably. It's not like giving up, they'll basically change the way technology works and HFO based ACs will be banned to use. Basically, the ACs which we use now are R22, R410 gas type ACs, which is again a refrigerant, which is even used in refrigerators. By the way, even our refrigerators also contribute to the greenhouse gases. Everybody has refrigerators these days, right? So imagine how much of greenhouse gases we are causing. There was a study I remember which I read. Man, you know what just happened? The light fell down. When you have very less budget, this is what happens. Well, I remember a study which I read which said in 2009, 96% of Americans had air conditioners in their home. That's like the 6% of total energy uses of world. So that's like it produced about 100 million tons of carbon dioxide that year. That's too much. That's way out of carrying capacity of our environment. And that's what AC does. When you stay cool, the world stays warm. That's all for this video, guys. You're watching Prehistoric Polymath. I'm Prateek Texavi. If you like the content of what and all I do, make sure you hit that subscribe button and press that bell icon and give this video a like, guys. This was such an informative video, and share this video, let everyone know what they are actually doing to the world. And comment down below, what do you feel about this technology, the homochlorolefins technology, which is coming now. And that's all for this video, guys. Stay tuned till the next video comes. Stay hungry, well, in terms of knowledge.